But the Bible says, let the word of Christ, Colossians 3 verse 16, dwell in you richly. So I want to ask you a question. How did the disciples grow in the word? When Jesus resurrected, where is the seed of Satan? That means on this earth, there are several kinds of people. We claim there are 7.2 billion people on the earth, human beings. We are so wrong, because there are people on this earth that are descendants of the serpent, Satan. They are not possessed. Salvation is not for them, because salvation is for men. These people, we are not talking of evangelism and born again. Are we together? That in your earth now, your territory, there are people, just the same way Satan cannot receive salvation, the same way Satan can't be saved, can't be born again, there is a descendant, there is a generation of a species of people, not in the spirit, not in planet Mars, not in Pluto, on earth now, they walk around your environment, but they are not humans. Just follow me. It is not hidden in the Bible that we are not alone. From Genesis to Revelation, you see that there has been an interference. Human beings have at several points encountered angels, encountered Jesus. Is that true? Encountered spirit. If you listen, some of you, if you understand what I'm saying, before I finish talking, you will see that certain diseases will just leave. This thing is an old story. Just follow me. Are we together? Now, theologically speaking, give us Genesis chapter 6. Those of us who have, God has granted grace to do a little study, you would have learned. Hallelujah. The Bible says it came to pass. Look up, please. When men began to multiply, remember, multiply was a command God gave men. So men were doing what was correct. Men began to multiply. How? Through reproduction. So it is all right for a man to impregnate a woman and have a child. God designed it that way. Are we together now? Listen carefully. And then the Bible says, daughters were born unto them. Next verse. That the sons of God, now, hold on carefully, that there were a group of people who were watching what was going on earth, where men were reproducing and multiplying. The Bible calls them sons of God. This translation in itself is an error, because it has created problem in the body of Christ. Are we together? Because people think these sons of God is the same that Jesus says, as many as received him. I hope you know that the translation of the Bible was not done by angels. It was done by human beings with their imperfections, who were also influenced at several. It is the potency of the scripture that is unbendable. But the linguistic of it, you need the Spirit of God. If not, by itself it can deceive you, because human beings wrote it down. Are we okay now? The sons of God saw that the daughters of men were fair. So whoever this group of people are, we know they are not men. Do we agree? Look at it. The Bible says those, whoever they are, that they saw on earth that they were a group of women. The word fair there just means they were beautiful. So these people had emotions. They could see a beautiful woman and be attracted to her. Are we together now? And then the Bible says, and they took them wives of all that they chose. Question. Do you think the women will see a beast waving his hands? Sister, if I came to you with wings and drop with light flashing and I say I love you, wouldn't you run? The Bible says they took wives. It didn't say they raped them. There was something Satan told the women. Those descendants, and made them follow and became wives. And then the Bible says, the Lord said, my spirit and all of that. Go to verse 4. And then he says there were giants in the earth. He's now telling us the product of this union between these entities and the daughters of men. That there were giants in the earth in those days. And after that, he said, when the sons of God came into the daughters of men, they bear what? Please talk to me. Children. Now, children is a human term. You don't use children for angels. You don't use children for all of this. So something had happened between these spirits and these women, and the result is physical. Children, just like your child. Are you seeing that now? And the Bible says, the same became mighty men which were of old, men of renown. Stop. Where are these children today? Giants are just a side effect, but that's not the only thing the union produced. Because the Bible says they were children. Are we together? The word sons of God there, it gave birth, theologically speaking, many of you have studied it. One of the class of these offsprings were called the Nephilim. Are we together now? Yes. The Nephilim here talk about that aberration. The original word Nephilim means the fallen ones. Are we together now? Rebels that were a product of this union, and the Bible says they gave birth to physical children, meaning you would see them and say, good morning, sir. You would think it's just another human and another human, but the Bible says these people you see are not pure human beings. This birth did not happen in heaven. Now, there are many theologians. I don't want to waste our time tonight. But this has been an argument between teachers of the gospel for many years, that it cannot have been angels. Why? Because two scriptures that the Bible says, to none of the angels did he say, thou art my son. I told you there is a mistake. The word there is benign Elohim. The word that is translated there is not just the word son, like an offspring of a person. I hope you know that Lucifer was not the first to throw down angels. There have been angels that have fallen, but it was not under Lucifer's leadership. There are angels that are bound in chains now that Lucifer has nothing to do with. They are not his offspring. He was not the cause, but they fell. The lake of fire did not start now. It's been there. It's a system of God's justice. Angels have their wills. They can choose to rebel. Are you listening to me now? Please understand what I'm teaching you. And then the Bible says, these men came and got wives. The women, I don't know whether they thought they were marrying human beings or marrying whatever. But one thing the Bible tells us clearly is that the children that came from these women were strange. Now listen carefully. And then the Bible tells us, go to verse 5. Let me see where we can stop. And God saw, notice, the mention of wickedness happened the moment these offsprings came. Listen. Men were already bad, but the wickedness did not touch God. But when these angels mixed with a human race, the offspring that came, they came with a level of wickedness that a pure human being cannot produce. That is true that men fell, but it was not so wicked. Hear what the Bible says, that God saw that the wickedness of man now was great in the earth, and every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was evil continually. These guys had done something to the race. And hear what God said. God, oh, your God, and it repented God that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him in his heart. What kind of wickedness did these Nephilim introduce that made things so bad? Listen, you look at our world today and see certain levels of wickedness and inhuman activity. A human being cannot do it. Have you seen where there is an accident? And you see people, it's not whether they are Christians or Muslims. They run to help the person. Those are men. Because no matter their differences, they still have that sense of sympathy. But there are men whose behavior is not human. So we're discussing something here that is a very, very serious subject. That he said, woman, there will be something between you and this serpent. You are going to have offsprings, Christ being the chiefest of them. But make no mistake, this guy you see is going to find a way of bringing an offspring too. So eventually it will be a clash of offsprings. That Satan has his own offsprings on earth. The angels that did not keep their original...